Last time we got quite far with the BFA motor. The casing halves are together, the bottom end is good to go. What's still missing now are all the components that are bolted onto the engine from the outside. That's the clutch, the barrel, the ignition, gear selector box, kickstart, and, a bit special on the BFA engine, the reed valve assembly with the inlet manifold. And that's where we will start straight away. The BFA engine has one detail that is unique. It's this reed valve assembly, pointing straight into the barrel. That's to that area between the barrel and the crankshaft. That's the ideal position, really. That requires special parts, though, for the reed valve and the inlet manifold. BFA's original concept, the original manifold and the original reed valve do work exceptionally well. The parts that come with the kit. It's based on a card reed, which really makes great power and is really nice. You may use other reed valve assemblies, though. Like this one here, by Italkit. It has one advantage. It's great value for money, and it is very nice quality. The frame and the stuffer are cast aluminium, and the 8 reeds themselves are carbon fiber. You don't have to use this, but you can use it, with minor modifications. In my case, there is a simple reason for my using it. I already had one. One I have modified already. As you can see, I cut off the tongs for the bolts, and I will show you in a second what else needs modifying for this to fit in here. You then, of course, also need something to connect the reed with the carburetor. This is the second advantage of us using the Italkit reed, because we have this brand new reed manifold by MRP. It's CNC made and exactly fits the Italkit reed's contour. There are different versions of these, for the original reed, for the Italkit. You can mount it directly, or you can turn the thing and use it with a hose. Then the carb sits a bit further forward. My personal preference is as short an inlet tract as possible, hence I will use it in this direction. The next thing is the rubber connector to fit the carb. I'll use the BFA rubber connector. It has the advantage that it nicely fits this 70mm hole spacing, and that it's extremely short and built around a very strong support structure, and that modern large carbs fit the hole without problems. Before we start fitting the reed valve, we need to modify it a bit, as I have said already. Since the reed originally was not intended for the BFA engine. But this reed model has the advantage that it comes from the same card and from the same motorcycle as the BFA reed. That means it is easy enough to modify. As you can see here, the balls of the original structure stand proud and need to be shortened. The next thing then is matching the balls to the original balls of the BFA engine. There need to be 4 holes on the side. You can see these here on the inlet manifold. And you need to file half moon shaped recesses into the reed body so that you can see the bolts from here. So next up is to the workbench and some filing. I need to be careful here to leave enough sealing surface. That's a tight fit. The reach cage now fits. The recesses for the bolts are there, and now we'll fit the reed valve. And since this now is a modified reed not originally intended for this, it's not simply using a gasket. That doesn't matter though, because we have a great and very clean gasket surface. And what's more important still, we have sealing compound. Great silicon sealer, and that's what I'll use in between these two, because it is great for sealing gaps. And with that, it will work a treat. Now a bit of Loctite here.
Jetzt muss nur noch das
now the rubber
Gummi montiert werden.
And because this will be tight here around the cooling air duct, I have shortened the rubber a bit. Or rather, as you can see here, it is attached to some relatively massive aluminium. And now it goes onto this here. So, inlet's done. A few other things are still missing, among them the clutch. The clutch supplied by BFA is something unique in the way it works, nothing like it in the market. We've shot a video about that where we talked about everything in detail, about the components that comprise the clutch and how it works. And that clutch precisely I will now fit to my engine. Okay, all parts here. I'm using a version with 24 teeth to get a slightly taller transmission ratio. Don't need this thing here. As you see, the primary drive has already been fitted. And I'll now start building up the clutch and to fit it there. Here's the actuation bearing. Here are the different spacers. Here the O-ring. Soak the clutch plates in oil overnight, or add some oil prior to fitting, which is what I do. Did you see that? The oil bottle is broken. Let's better fit this here, for it to be properly positioned later. The plates sometimes need a bit of convincing to fit into the clutch. In the inner basket, that's the steel plates. Doesn't matter though, because it's not relevant for its function. There is no grabbing or anything like that. After revving it up for the first time, the steel plates will slide properly in the clutch. Bam! All parts where they need to be. Brass washer, bearing, everything there. Now this spacer goes onto the crankshaft. And now the clutch with its teeth easily slides onto the crankshaft. And now this nut with the integrated washer, torque it down properly. Fit the bolt, fit the nut. Use the standard clutch holding tool for this. Tighten down properly. Last, not least, the pressure plate with its bearing goes into the middle here, over that nut. Remains in its place because it's jammed in there with an O-ring. Each clutch kit contains these two shim washers, and they are there to space the pressure plate to the right distance to the plunger piston in the clutch cover. To do that, I need the clutch cover first. Make sure the clutch cover has a large enough groove for the lay shaft, so that it does not touch the nut that secures the lay shaft. The next thing you'll see is that I have completely removed this ridge here that guides the oil. If you do not modify that, it may foul the outer clutch basket. Please double check this. And third, other than that, it's a standard clutch cover. It's not machined or anything. The actuating arm is not modified either. Let's see whether this works. I'll first fit the pressure plate to the clutch with no shims. Now, I'll take the clutch cover. First test, does the clutch rub? I move the crankshaft up and down and, as you can see, it does not rub. A clutch cover that has not been machined, that means the clutch fits into a standard clutch cover. Right. The reason why I do this is this here. I have here an actuating arm and the plunger piston should just touch the pressure plate when the actuating lever is perpendicular to the scooter's center line or to the engine. Now, when I work this here, you can see I have a little more travel before the plunger piston touches the pressure plate. That means I'll have to remove the cover and I'll add the smaller shim to the pressure plate.
Ausgleichsscheibe unter die Andruckplatte. Also ich nehme jetzt die Andruckplatte
out with
raus.
The pressure plate and in with the thinner of the two shims.
Ich nehme die dünnere der beiden Ausgleichsscheiben und stecke die.
There it goes, between clutch and pressure plate.
Andruckplatte.
Now the pressure plate sits a bit further up and the lever should now be at the right angle, I hope.
Im richtigen Winkel stehen.
Now, this is the ideal position. The lever touches in the right moment, or the plunger piston in the cover touches the pressure plate in precisely the right moment. That's with the lever perpendicular, or possibly even a bit earlier. Now, the clutch should work exactly as it should. Now the kickstart goes on, and the kickstart too is slightly different on a BFA engine. As you can see, there is precious little space here between the air duct and the kickstart shaft. On other engines, the air duct is a bit further down. Here on the BFA engine, with its Y crankshaft and everything, it sits slightly further to the right. That means here is little space. That's why we offer a kickstart modified for the BFA engine. Up here, there is a bolt or a nut. Up here, countersunk. And it sits nice and low and hidden and can be tightened from below. Okay, here's something new. Our lovely new SIP kickstarts. This one here is, as you can see, for a rally in black. I think they have a lovely shape and the black too should work well with what I want. Hence, I decided to use one. Unfortunately, there isn't one modified for BFA yet. Hence, I had to do that myself. I have heli-coiled it up here and I will fit this now. Okay. As you can see, this unfortunately is not exactly elegant with my heli-coil solution. The BFA version is already on its way though. So you will be able to fit it and it will look nice. That was it for today. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Like us if you enjoyed this. Ciao.